Hi, I'm Dr. Vipul Gupta, and in this short video, we'd like to tell you about cerebral angiography. When do we do it and how do we do it? So what is cerebral angiography? Everybody here heard about coronary angiography, or we call as heart angiography. Same way as the cardiologists do it for the heart, we do it for the brain. So the angiography is a minimally invasive medical test that uses X-rays and iodine-containing contrast material to produce pictures of blood vessels of the brain. Now in brain, we very commonly call it intra-arterial digital suppression angiography, or DSA. Now what is DSA? Now it refers to acquiring the images electronically rather than just with the X-ray film. And these images are manipulated so as to remove the overlying bone of the skull, and which makes the underlying blood vessels very, very clear, as you can see in this adjacent image. So how is it done? In cerebral angiography, a thin plastic tube is inserted through the leg blood vessel through a very small incision in the skin, and under X-ray guidance, it is taken to the area to be examined, and we inject dye there, which you call as contrast material, through this catheter of the tube, and the images are captured using ionizing radiation, or the X-rays. So when do we do an angiography? Basically, angiography will be done by a doctor when they feel that need to diagnose something wrong with the blood vessels, and is very important to diagnose it right. Most commonly, it is done for investigation of stroke, whether ischemic stroke, paralytic attacks, or for brain hemorrhage, to look for the cause and to treat it. One of the very important reasons to do angiography is to look for brain aneurysms, which are swelling the brain blood vessels and which can cause a very deadly kind of brain hemorrhage known as subarachnoid hemorrhage. It is also done to look for a bunch of swollen abnormal blood vessels, which we call as vascular malformations, which can again cause hemorrhage in the brain. It is also done during the part of a stroke procedure to look for the clot which may have caused the stroke, and sometimes we can take out that clot as well to remove the patient. It is also done to look for the narrowings in the blood vessel of the brain, which we call as stenosis, which can again result in brain stroke, and to study the blood vessels of brain tumors before the surgery. And sometimes we, through the angiography method, we also close the blood supply to the brain tumor so that surgeon can operate upon it. There are many other reasons where the doctor, treating doctor, feels that we need a very fine information, and then this test is ordered. So how is angiography done? Now angiography is done in neuroangiography suite, which we also call as DSA lab, and in the picture we have shown our biplane DSA lab here in our hospital. So patient is initially always awake, they are clean and draped with sterile sheets. They remain awake during the procedure, but what we do is something known as local anesthesia around the leg blood vessel, which is a painkiller injection, so that patient doesn't feel any pain during the procedure. Every patient wants to be very comfortable nowadays. And then through that small area, we insert a tube, which is known as the catheter, through the groin blood vessels. And under fluoroscopy guidance, the X-ray guidance, we take the catheter to the appropriate blood vessel which we want to study. And all the while, doctors can see on the screens where the catheter is going so that it doesn't injure any normal blood vessel. And then the dye injection is done to obtain this kind of DSA pictures. After the procedure, which takes commonly from 15 to 30 minutes, the catheter is taken out and just a compression is done. A little pressure is applied for 10 to 15 minutes to close the puncture site, and a small bandage is applied which can be removed the next day. So angiography really helps the doctor, whether it's neurologist, neurophysician or neurointerventionist, to diagnose the deadly diseases in an absolute accurate manner, and to make the right diagnosis and right treatment, whether it's carotid artery stenosis, AVMs, aneurysms, or during stroke. And to take the right decision for the patient, and to enable right diagnosis and early recovery for our patients. Thank you.